Hey YouTube, it's Dylan James, and on today's video, we're going to be talking about the new record that was set for the most expensive sports card in history, and we're also going to dive in to see if it's actually worth its $5.9 million valuation. So earlier this week, the alternative assets platform Alt announced their purchase of a 2009-10 National Treasures Logo Man One of One of Steph Curry that they valued at $5.9 million after they purchased 51% majority stake in the card, with the other 49% being purchased by a private buyer. And there has been a lot of speculation on if this card is actually worth the $5.9 million valuation, or if this was a sale at all, because we don't know what happened with the other 49% and how much that buyer actually spent on the card. So on today's episode, we're gonna be taking a deeper dive into this card to see if there are comps out there that are comparable to this card, and to see if the valuation of 5.9 is actually somewhere in the ballpark of what this card is actually valued at. So the NBA Finals started this week, but Steph Curry is nowhere near the NBA Finals, but he still managed to take away the headlines for a day or two with this purchase of this card. $5.9 million valuation of this card. This is the card that we are questioning today. The 2009 Playoff National Treasures Logo Man One of One. It has an autograph that has a 10 rating from PSA. The card itself is a near mint, mint 8. So very good grades there, especially for an older card such as this 2009. But is it worth the value that Alt gave it and this private buyer gave it this week? Now we'll look at some other players and look at some other cards that are comparable to this situation, and I'll leave the judgment up to you. So let's first start off with the Luka Doncic One of One Logo Man from his rookie year. So similar to the Steph Curry card. However, Luka is at the beginning of his career, and Steph Curry is in the middle, closer to the end of his career. And there's more upside to Luka instead of Steph Curry at this point. We know what Steph Curry is on the court. We know how he is as a player because he is 33 now. He's been in the league for quite some time, but he is a very, very good player in this league. One of the top at least 25 players in this league. Now, we look at Luka. Luka's card sold for $4.6 million, the One of One Logo Man. So that's a card that has some tremendous upside. Was this card overvalued when it was purchased? I'll leave that up to you. But $4.6 million is quite the gamble for a player who's only been in the league for 3 years. Now, here's a player that has been compared to Michael Jordan, who some consider to be the greatest of all time, LeBron James. This LeBron James card, back just a few months ago in April, April 26th, was sold on PWCC. It was a private sale of a BGS 9 Mint 2003-04 Upper Deck Exquisite Jersey Patch Parallel Autograph card of LeBron James, $5.2 million. And this card was out of 23, so it was not one of one. There were still other comps out there for this card, but it still sold for a record-setting price of $5.2 million. So the Luka card sold for the 4.6 in February, and then just a few months later is when this card was sold at 5.2. So it got the top spot. It actually tied with a 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle card as the most expensive card ever sold. Now let's look at some statistics as well, because this is going to play into the value of these cards a bit as well when it comes to scarcity. Now, scarcity is one thing that, being a one of one, you don't have any other comps for this card besides other comparable players potentially. And in this card, it's very, very hard to put a value on. A one of one is very, very hard to put a value on. Most collectors don't even grade one of one simply because it might be worse than what it is raw. I mean, the value of it might go down given the grade it might receive at PSA, at BGS, at one of those companies. So let's look at Luka's numbers. Luka's numbers in his career so far, he's gone to two All-Star games. He's two-time All-NBA player as well, All-Rookie and Rookie of the Year in 2018-19. But his field goal percentage, 45.7%. Field goal percentage from the three-point line, 33.1%. So not very good for his career so far compared to the other two players we were talking about. So let's talk about LeBron James next. LeBron James has a ton of accolades during his career. He is a 17-time All-Star. He's won the NBA Finals MVP four times. And he's just gotten all the accolades that you possibly can think of in the league. LeBron is a good two-way player as well, offense and defense. And so this is a very, very good comparison to Michael Jordan. He is a modern-day Michael Jordan in some people's eyes, and he is considered the GOAT in other people's eyes as well. But let's look at Steph Curry's numbers in his career, and we can look at this too before we go. LeBron James, 50.4% field goal percentage, effective field goal percentage at 54.3%. So still good numbers there. Field goal percentage from the three-point line, 34.5%. Pretty good. But then we look at Steph Curry's numbers. Steph Curry is 43.3% from the three-point line, field goal percentage of 47.7%, and a 58.3% effective field goal percentage in the league. He doesn't have as many accolades as LeBron James does. He's been with the Golden State Warriors his entire career, and LeBron has jumped around a few times. So if Steph had gone to other teams like LeBron had, do you think that he might have received more, you know, acknowledgement for his play? He might have. But in this situation, he's had 7 All-Stars. He has 2 MVPs. He has 3 NBA championships and 2 scoring championships as well. I believe LeBron James only has 1. So Steph Curry has had a tremendous career. And with this Logo Man card being a 101, yes, it does, you know, it does have a really good valuation on it of $5.9 million. But is it overvalued? Is it undervalued? Let's look at the list of most expensive cards from Wikipedia. This is a really, really good running list to look at every once in a while to see what's out there. And it also adjusts the price for you based on inflation as well. So the top 2 cards, the Mickey Mantle and LeBron James, it still doesn't have the Stephen Curry card on here because it's not considered a sale. It's a one-time sale of $5.9 million because there was a private buyer involved as well. So we don't know what that portion of the sale was. But as of right now, the $5.2 million is the most expensive card for these 2 cards here. Luka Doncic at 4.6. Now, with the valuation of 5.9 and with Alt purchasing 51% of this card, it still would be the number 6 most expensive card on this list if it was sold for that valuation. However, it is the full valuation of 5.9, so there's still some questions there as to, is this the right valuation for it? Should this card be higher? Should this card be lower? And that's just a question I'll leave up to you. So there's just a few examples of some cards that are comparable to the Steph Curry card that sold this week. Now, private sales, I believe, happen quite often in the sports card world, but we just don't know those values of those cards because most of the time, those sales are not made public to us. And your guess is as good as mine on the validity of this story. Given the fact we've heard from Alt, but we haven't heard from the private buyer in this scenario who purchased the other 49% of this card. So was this card overvalued, undervalued, or just right? Let us know in the comments below. We'd love to get your thoughts on that. And if you like this video, hit that like button, click the subscribe button, and push that notification bell. So whenever we drop a new video, you'll be the first to know about it. Thanks once again for watching, guys. We'll see you next week.